Welcome viewers, welcome to another video of BioGuide. In this video today we will discuss about different cell junction. So what is cell junction that we should discuss first? Cell junctions are cellular structures. They are made up of multi-protein complexes and they actually do the connection. They provide contact or adhesion between the neighboring cells or between one cell and extracellular matrix. Generally, these are found in animals. Also, these are found in some plants also. So how many different types of cell junctions are there? Those we will discuss. Basically, invertebrates, these are of basically three types. One is the first adherence junction. Among these adherence junction, there are desmosome, hemidesmosome and adherence junction. These are actually called adherence junction. Desmosome and hemidesmosomes are called anchoring junctions. Next, there are communicating junctions or gap junctions. And the third one, occluding junctions or tight junction. So first one we will discuss about anchoring junction. From the name you can understand the anchor. Anchoring means connecting, they connect. So among them we will discuss about desmosome, hemidesmosome and adherence junction. So what are the desmosomes? If you see this diagram, there you can see this is the left one is the desmosome. You can see there two plasma membranes are there. These two plasma membranes are connected in a zipper-like arrangement using cadherin. What happens, these plasma membranes are basically connected with intermediate filament. For example, in this diagram you can see keratin filament. So desmosomes are those connecting links which will connect intermediate filament with plasma membrane using a specific cell adhesion molecule named cadherin. So desmosome ties one cell to another cell using the anchoring intermediate filament, and there is a two type of anchors are basically used. One is cytoskeletal anchor, another is transmembrane anchor. Cytoskeletal anchor is the intermediate filament and the transmembrane anchor is the cadherin. So they actually connects one cell to another cell. Cell to cell connection. Next, coming to hemidesmosome, mostly found in the epithelial cell. You know, the epithelial cells, they lie on a basement membrane. So they, what does they do? These epithelial cells can be connected with the extracellular matrix. This is mediated by two kinds of anchors. Again, like desmosomes, these are mediated by the cytoskeletal anchor intermediate filament and the transmembrane linker integrins. So integrin connects using the intermediate filament, they connect one cell to the extracellular matrix. So this is the importance of hemidesmosome. Now, adherence junction, very, very important. In the other two, we found that one cell is being connected by intermediate filament. But in the case of adherence junction, it is actually using microfilament like actin filament, and it can connect one cell to another cell, or it can connect one cell to the extracellular matrix using actin filament. And again here the transmembrane linker is cadherin or integrin. So it's a basically you can tell it has both of the characters of desmosomes and hemidesmosomes. In this diagram you can see in the top right corner, this is adherence junction. These small globular structures are actually G-actin, and this G-actin monomer of one cell or extracellular matrix is connected to G-actin monomer to another using cadherin in when it is between membrane to membrane and also by actin filaments. Now coming to other two type of junctions, one is gap junction and another is tight junction. While in the case of the last one, what I have discussed, that was the anchoring junction. From the name you understood, they anchor or connect. While gap junction is also called communication junction because it allows the chemical communication through diffusion but without contact with the extracellular fluid. So how it is mediated? If you see the diagram, it will be easier for you to understand. There are two membranes. These are the cell membrane. And among them, there are channels. So how these channels are formed? These channels are actually forms this gap junction. So these channels are formed by connexin protein. Six connexin protein together, they interact and form a cylinder with pores in it. So you can understand from one cell to another cell, the signaling molecules can pass through this particular channel, and thus cell to cell communication will be mediated. So you may ask me that, there the molecules are going through this gap junction. Where you may ask one question that in which kind of cells you can find gap junction? Example is in the heart muscle, in contractile heart muscle, you can see the gap junction. Otherwise, gap junction is also important in the signal transduction in brain. And also it is important the retinal cell and the skin cells are dependent on gap junction for cell differentiation and proliferation. This is the last one, which is tight junction. Tight, the thing in my mind, whenever you will hear this, you will think that tight means something which is sealing. Yes, you are right. They're actually sealing the connection between two cells and acting as a barrier. So it is basically found in vertebrate epithelia. They act as barrier that regulate the movement of water and solute between the epithelial cells. Now these barriers, these are basically protein complex. So what kind of proteins are there? This can be four types of proteins. One is signaling proteins, can be transmembrane proteins. For example of transmembrane proteins, they are junctional adhesion molecule, JAM, occludin and claudin. This can be regulation protein as well as scaffolding protein. Their main act is to seal or act as a barrier between two cells in order to regulate the movement of water and solutes between the layers of epithelial cell. So why should we study about these junctions? Because the cell-to-cell communication is very much important for the normal activity. And not only that, any abnormality in the connection can lead to several problems. And this problem can give rise to several disorders, malfunction in the cells, as well as it can bring to several. For example, if there is any problem that the epithelial cells are not resting on the basement membrane, rather they are getting loosened and migrating through the circulation, it can go refuge to a new location where it is not supposed to be there. And there it can form a new colony, which might be wrong for the cellular health or the health of the organism as well. So, and it is also a very important topic for any entrance exam. So if you want to study, go through many books, particularly books of cell biology. And if you like this video, please let me know through the comment section. Not only that, if you want to do a discussion on the cell adhesion molecule, let me know in the comment section. And if you like my video, please press like, share my video, and subscribe to BioGuide. Thank you so much.